Alright guys, this is a very quick video of the generic eBay gimbal right here for the QRX 350 Pro and the devo7. It's going to make it roll up and down when you turn the knob because it comes with zero instructions, just a bunch of parts in a box. So first thing, you have to take it apart. Be careful. When you are taking the top off, the GPS cable is plugged into the side, the WM. Take it off a little bit, pull the cable out, the top comes off. You're going to need a 1.5mm hex, 2mm hex. You can get these for like 10 bucks or so. A lot of places sell them. These are really good ones. Obviously, you take the screws out, which I set them over here, and the leg mounts. When you take the top off, it's going to have a zip tie or something in here. You have to cut that off. Also, the USB cable goes over top of the receiver right in here, so you have to unplug that. Then you pull your receiver out some. It has sticky tape on it. It will come out and just wiggle it and pull a little bit. What we're looking for here, focus. All right, that's the receiver here. First one's data bus, second one's auxiliary, third one's auxiliary 2. For auxiliary 2, the pin to the left is what you want to use. Now you can use the stock cable that comes with it, which I personally don't like, and it's very short, so I just took it out. I had an extra one laying around here, a bunch of different colors on it, so I just took the blue one off, and that's what I'm going to use. There's a hole down here for the compass, I believe. Gonna run the wire through there and plug it into here and run up to the front of the quad so I can get to the front of the gimbal because we need to get to those pins on top. So like I said, we're gonna keep it short. I'm not gonna make you watch me do all these little things, so just give me a minute and I'll be right back. Alright guys, so I got it back together. Just didn't mention, you take out four screws in each arm, 1, 2, 3, 4. These four are for the motor, so those don't come out, leave them in. All the screws are 1.5mm hex. The ones that come with the gimbal are 2, so they are a different size. I already got the wires for the compass and the blue one that we added to auxiliary 2. Running through the legs with the antennas. This part's a little bit tricky. What you want to do, take the bottom, turn it this way. You gotta use these holes. Okay, so it's the first one, second to last one. Because if you don't, when you get to screw these in, it's gonna be a problem. So, I don't know if I can do this one-handed or not. Let's see if I can. Okay, that one's in. Okay, those in first. Okay. Now you can just screw that in if you want. It doesn't really matter. But these have to go in here in this order. Like, so legs, this thing, these screws. I probably would screw this in first, actually. Let me do that. Because if you don't, this is gonna slide around. And these are really hard again. You gotta push a little bit to get them tight in there. You're not gonna wanna over-tighten it. I just tighten them enough, finger tight. They do have the hex socket if you want to, but I don't want to break or snap anything. So let me do that, and I'll be back in a minute. Okay, so that's installed now. Sorry for the skipping and jumping, but I don't have a tripod, and it's really hard to do this kind of stuff with one hand. I mean, like I said, you just want to... The legs on this thing, screws, and there's, right? Get the gimbal. Little side note though, I always work on a towel. In case you drop a screw or something, or if you just have to set something down, it doesn't roll off the table. If you drop it, it doesn't bounce and roll, it just stops. So it's a good idea if you're new to this hobby. For the gimbal, what you want to do, run your red wire through it like this. And I'm gonna run this one, let's see, through it the other way. So I'll do it like that. Like that. This one to the receiver, there's really two. The first one to the left, if it's sitting upright, you just go by the closest one to the main board in there. That's what we're using, the pin. These are always fun. Because I squeeze them. You stick it through, and then you can pull on it a little bit, and then you get something not sharp, and push it through. Or if you have like a pair of needle nose laying around, something's not going to tear them up. You kind of work it through. This is going to take a couple minutes. Okay, so it's all mounted on. Gimbal's running through the front. You have to have weight on this gimbal. If you don't have anything on it, it's going to go twitch nuts. So put your camera on it. For the Devo 7, you have to make sure it's set right. So let me see. Do is push this button. Okay, go to model, enter, output, enter, auxiliary 2, you want auxiliary 2, okay, so if you change it, use this button, enter, and then blow it, act. Take the wire, which I want to use, whatever color it is. There's two sets of three, total six, right? So the ones, if it's facing you, the top one on the left is what you want. And you just plug it in to, I'm not using an old battery because I don't need that much power, the balance port. Flashing. Okay. I'm gonna plug in the quad's power. There you go. So that's how you install the generic, usually eBay brushless gimbal with no instructions, no help whatsoever. It's a very important video. It's very hard to find this stuff. That's why I made a video on it. I don't even like making these kind of videos. But there you go, guys. If there's any questions, leave them in the comments below. You can subscribe. I put videos up often, not, you know, on schedule or regularly, but let me know what you think.